Hello everybody. Today I will talk about how to do about statement of cost of goods manufactured. This one on the CBA test, and we need to learn how to do about statement of cost of goods manufactured. First, we will begin work in the process inventory. At the beginning, we put this number on the right side because this one will be you to transfer the cost of goods sold at the end. We have direct material. This one is the small one. In calculate direct material, we have material inventory at the beginning. Purchase, we sum two numbers together. We got about the total 511,000. This one is the basic one in the first. We need to learn about calculate direct material. Then we minus about material inventory at the end, so that we got about 357,000, and this is about direct material will be used in a work in process. And we have direct labor, this is the given number that we provide for you. Factory overhead, we just summed on the number in here. Indirect labor and indirect material, they will be in the factory overhead. We sum together, we have 80,200. We have direct material, direct labor, factory overhead. We sum three numbers together. We have total manufacturing cost incurred. This number used for work in process. So that after we calculate work in process available for using, we have work in process at the beginning on the top one, plus 752,200, so that we have a total 871,200. This is a total manufacturing cost, and we minus about work in process ending. So that we have cost of goods manufactured. This number will transfer the cost of goods manufactured for the finished good. So in the finished good inventory at the beginning, we have 91,000. We have 738,200. Move to the cost of goods manufactured in here. We have cost of finished good available for sale, and later that we minus about finished good ending inventory. That's about 105,000. So that we have cost of goods sold. This is 724,200. So that there are three tables. The first one, that's about direct material. The second table, that's about work in process. And the third table, this is about finished goods. So that there are three tables we need to calculate in here, so that we can get about the cost of goods sold at the end. So that's the end of my video. Thank you for watching.